So the West Indies were all set to take on the winner of the fourth quarter final. And two young Canterbury lads were going to make sure New Zealand had every chance of making the semis.
What a good start that is. And that's gone away too, and that'll be four as well. They've got that away beautifully as well. That's a lovely shot. That really wasn't that bad a delivery. Oh, he's got him. That's out caught behind. Yes, he's gone for the big one. And unfortunately, that's a huge nick. That's out two. He's caught behind. Yes, that's two down. Going after that wide one again. This is Fleming. He's got that one away nicely. That's a very good shot. That's well played. That's a beautiful shot. That's a magnificent shot. Off the back foot, right off the meat of the bat. Time to perfection.
It's a good shot. It may stop on bouncing. Bounce on the hard into the outfield. And, in fact, it's going to go over the boundary line. Good stroke. Gone. Now, that's a real blow for New Zealand after the loss of the first two. Fleming has hit it straight to square point just inside the circle, and Steve Waugh is the man taking the catch. That's safe. It's beaten the man at point, and we'll go for four. Good shot. He has whipped that away straight over the fence at mid-wicket. That is a tremendous blow.
Beautifully balanced when he hits the shot. Look at the momentum going into it, this full swing of the arms, and that carries over mid-wicket. It's the ultimate.
Another good shot. All right, well, we'll see now how focused Glenn McGrath is, because this has happened to him on a couple of earlier occasions in this competition. Inside the 15 overs, there's a big chance of hitting straight down the ground. It's good stuff.
Oh, that's well hit. That's six over cover point. Magnificent shot. That's beautiful time. So the bounce is also good for the batsman. They can play the horizontal bat shots. And this time he goes over mid-off. Beautifully hit. This is Lee Germon's best score in one-day internationals. His first half century. Harris is going to go over the top. He'd be better going straight where the boundaries are short.
It's a beautifully straight. A clean blow by Chris Harris and another boundary. Harris goes after him again. And that's another boundary. Short and wide and dispatched.
He's one played. This one away, and it's going to go for four. It's found the gap.
Well, that's well played. That's over the top, going down towards square leg two. They are playing well.
They need to chase that. They'll have to throw it back from the bleachers. Tremendous strike.
Well, this is a phenomenal shot from Chris Harris. It really is. Look how wide he gets it from. It's a slower ball. He picks all of that. And then he picks it up beautifully, and that has gone miles. It's a two-tiered stand here, and it is into the middle part of the second tier. Huge hit.
That's it. That's a very, very good 100. Chris Harris has played superbly out there, and he did it in partnership with his captain, Lee Germon, and it has been quite something to see.
286 at night, under lights. Well, it's got to be very, very tough run chase indeed. Australia are a class outfit. They're some class players. And Lee Germon there with Chris Harris, just a glimpse of him. Sure he took on a lot of fluids in between the innings. There's Madras at night. It's a beautiful scene, beautiful sunset. And the lights really here at the stadium taking their full effect.
Oh, there's a big appeal there for caught behind. The umpire's going to give him. Yes, he's given him. Well, I don't know whether he started to go. There was a huge appeal, and just for a second, I thought umpire Mitchley was walking away.
Beautifully played. Four runs. Puts it beautifully. That went slow. Beautiful shot. Hit straight. And out of the fence.
Excellent shot from Mark Waugh. It's found the gap. Even though the ball is slowing down as it gets near the rope. He's going the one way, which is to the onside. This time he's cleared the boundary. And that one's gone as well.
Yes, a big one. That has gone back many a row, if not many a mile. Placement once again. Another big hit. Long on and long off are pointing towards one another, but in fact they should be pointing up behind the side screen. Lovely shot. Not quite. And there is Mark Waugh's 100, one of his greatest. .194/3. That was absolutely magnificent. Well, it has now. And Mark Waugh will regret that. Dion Nash has come on and taken the wicket. And New Zealand are right back in the game. 213/4. Mark Waugh goes.
And it's got past third man. That's a big blow for Australia. Whoever wins this, that's a great shot from Stuart Law. So two boundaries in the last two overs from Stuart Law have helped Australia's cause. That's beautifully hit, hitting straight. There's always a gap there. And that's cleared the boundary.
Oh, he's got that one away, and it's running away to the fence as well. Yes, that's a lovely shot. He's got that one away as well. Well, Stephen Waugh and Stuart Law putting together a fantastic partnership, and it's Stuart Law who's starting to turn it on now. And that's victory to Australia. He's got that away fine. Four leg byes. And the Australians, having been in trouble at one stage, you can see they are pretty happy. I think they would have been very worried at one stage, but some pretty good partnerships and a pretty professional performance with the bat.